Hello everyone, to begin then, I'm going to be using an eye hook, which is a number 9. It's a 5.5 millimeter hook. Let me see, you can see that the size there. And I'm going to use a medium weight yarn. To begin the little mermaid tail, I'm just going to make my slip loop. And I'm going to chain 4. Okay, so here's 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now I'm going to slip stitch into the fourth chain, right? Excuse me, the first chain to close my circle, just like that. Okay, and now we're going to be working into this circle here. I'm going to be doing 14 double crochets into the circle. To go up, I'm going to chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. This counts as my first double crochet, okay, here and throughout. So I'm going to do the yarn over so that I can do my double crochet. Go over my yarn. I'm going to go into that circle and grab my yarn. There's 3 loops on the hook. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to pull through the first 2 and the second 2. I'm actually hiding the tail in my work as I go. If you don't, it doesn't really matter. It's going to be inside. But I just like to get those ends out because I don't want the child's foot to get caught in any yarn. The foot won't be able to fit here, but I still want to make it clean here. So here's 1, 2. So we're going to do 14. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, oops. Got that caught there. 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So now you have 14 double crochets into that circle. Let me count them to make sure I got them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, and then at 3 chains, 14. Okay, so now once you do that, you're going to slip stitch into the third chain that we made to go up. So here's 1, 2, 3. In the third chain is where you're going to put your hook in, pull out your yarn, and that will be where you close that stitch. And this is the where the little row is, the little ridge is forming. It will be your the back part of the tail. So here to go up for we want to repeat 14 stitches until we have 4 rows of 14 double crochets. So here I'm going to do 3 more rows of 1 double crochet in every stitch. So here you go up 1, 2, 3. This counts as our first double crochet. Now we're going to go in every stitch around, so you'll have 14 double crochets. When you get to the end, or when you finish your last double crochet here, you're going to slip stitch into the third chain, chain 3, and repeat once again until you have 4 rounds. So here's 1, 2, you're going to have 3, 4. So I'm going to repeat that, and then I'll come back, and then we'll go on to our next round. Okay, I've just finished the fourth round here. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've slip stitched into the third chain. And now to go up to my next row, I'm going to chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Now on the next 4 stitches, I'm going to do 1 double crochet. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4. So here on my next stitch now, not on the same one, I'm going to go 1 double crochet. So here's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, now on the fifth stitch, I'm going to do an increase. I'm going to do 2 double crochets, 1, and then 2. Now I'm going to repeat the same thing. So here, 1 double crochet in each of the next 4. So here's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now on the fifth stitch, I'm going to do an increase, so two double crochets in the next one. One, two, and one double crochet in each of the remaining stitches. It's only going to be one, two, three, okay? One, two, and three. We're just trying to work two increases into that row to start making it like more of a, you know, the tail section. And these are the sections where we're gonna sew the fin, the tail, the actual fin when we finish. So here, to go up to my next round, I'm gonna slip stitch into the third chain. One, two, three. And that will be my fifth round, okay? One, two, three, four, five, yeah. For the sixth round, we're gonna do the same thing. One, two, three, one double crochet in each of the next four. One, two, three, four, okay, and then in the fifth stitch, you're going to do an increase, so two double crochets in the next one. One and two. And I know I get some comments, you guys saying that I'm going too fast. Remember, if I'm going too fast, hit the pause button till you catch up, or you could do the rewind, guys. So here, the next, once again, I'm going to do the same thing I did here. One double crochet in each of the next four. So here's one. Two. Three. And four. Now, in the fifth stitch, we're going to do the increase. So here, two double crochets. One and two. Repeat again, one double crochet in each of the next stitches. So it's one, two, three, and four. So here's one, two, three, four. And here on the very last stitch, go ahead and do your increase. So you have two double crochets. Two. And now you're going to slip stitch into the third chain to close it up. One, two, and three. Okay. Now we'll move up to our next row. So you could see how it's starting to shape the tail. Okay, for our next row then, once again, chain three, one, two, three. This row into the same stitch that you went up there, you're going to do another double crochet there just to get an increase. And now you're just going to do one double crochet in every stitch across. So here's the first one. There's our next one. So it's just one double crochet in every stitch around. So let me go ahead and do that. And remember, some people say it goes that I'm going too fast. Just pause and rewind. I've tried going a little slower, but every time I do, I start messing up a lot because it's like in a natural rhythm for me, I guess. So here, I'll just do that. And we're almost coming to the end. Oops, let me see here. I hope that's not going to turn into a knot. Go all the way around. Okay, here I finished my last stitch. There's a little piece of lip there. So now I'm going to slip stitch into the third chain. One, two, three. Going to go up with three chains once again. One, two, three. And then here what we're going to do is the first stitch will have an increase, the next one no increase, the second with increase, the next one no increase. So it's every other stitch. So here, I'm going to yarn over, go into that same stitch to do my first increase, right there. And then my next stitch, which is right next to it, sometimes it's hard, it's easy to miss it, that it's right there. I'm going to do no increase. So this one is just one double crochet. The next stitch then would have two double crochets. Oops, there we go. Okay. Okie dokie. my thumbs here, and then one more. So I have an increase on the second one, and then the next one would have no increase. So I'm going to do that all the way around to try to get this a little bit wider here. And so go ahead and do that, and I will return for our next round, or next row really, because we're not working in rounds. But so here, one increase, no increase, increase, no increase, increase all the way around. Okay, so I finished my last stitch here. So to go up to my next row, once again into the third chain. This next row, there's only one double crochet in every stitch, so there's no increases. So here you just chain three to go up, one, two, three. Remember, this counts as our first stitch. So then on our next stitch here, which falls right on top of the other double crochet from the previous row, you're going to do just one double crochet in every stitch around, no increases. Just work one double crochet in every stitch. When we get to the end here, your last stitch there, you're going to slip stitch into the third chain to move up. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this round, and then I'll go up to my next, we'll come back to work up our next row. Okay, I finished my last stitch here, so I'm going to slip stitch into the third chain. I'm going to go up to my next row with three chains. Now here on the first, on the same stitch, I'm going to do an increase. I'm going to yarn over, go into that same stitch there, go up. And now I'm going to follow this pattern for the way all the way around. In the next two stitches, I'm going to do one double crochet, no increase. So here's one and two. Now on my third one, I will go ahead and do an increase. So one, two double crochets in the same stitch. Put some yarn here. And now the next two each have one double crochet. So you're going to repeat that all the way around. And one. Now the next stitch, the third stitch then, has an increase. Two double crochets. One, two. Now the next two each have one. One, two. And then your third, again, an increase, two double crochets. So you're going to repeat that all the way around, okay? Beginning with the very first stitch. Remember, the three chains count as one double crochet, so we have an increase, and then one, one, increase, one, one, increase, one, one, increase. So repeat that all the way around. When you get to the end, you're going to do your last stitch here, slip stitch once again into the third chain, and we'll come back and work on our next round. Okay, so here I finished my last stitch. I'm going to slip stitch into the third chain, and now you're going to go up with three, one, two, three, and for three rows, so for three different rows, you're going to do only one double crochet in every stitch, no increases for three times around. Okay, so here you're just going to do one and double crochet in every stitch all the way around. When you get to the last stitch of your row here, when you do your last stitch here, once again you're going to slip stitch into the third chain, chain three to go up, and then repeat what you just did right now. So it's going to be three rows total of only one double crochet in every stitch. So here's my first stitch. I'm going to finish these and I'll do my three rounds, and then we'll come back to keep working. Okay, here I finished my last stitch. I have pulled it out so I wouldn't lose my space. So what I want you to do before we go up, skipping this first stitch because we're going to be doing that our slip stitch into there. I guess we can just slip stitch in here. Just so we know we're not going to count this one, okay? You're going to chain three, one, two, three. Now I want you to take a stitch marker or something to, if you don't, you can count if you don't need to do that. But here what we're going to do, starting here on your second stitch, you're going to count 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Basically, we're just trying to get to the other side. We're going to mark there because we're going to do an increase there. The rest is only one double crochet, an increase in the beginning and the end. So put in your stitch marker there. And if you're off one stitch or over one, it doesn't matter. We're just trying to increase on the sides, okay? So here, what we're going to do now then, after you've done that, let me focus this a little bit better so you could see. So then here on the first stitch, we're going to do an increase. I'm going to yarn over and do a double crochet there. And then one double crochet in every stitch. Remember to get this one. It's easier to skip that, then your count will be off. So here, you're going to do one double crochet in every stitch until you get to your stitch marker, or the 20th stitch, really the 21st, but till you get your next one, until you've done 20 of these. And then on that stitch, you're going to, where your stitch marker is at, you're going to do another increase. So let me get over there. And let me get this there. And I'm gonna be telling you how many rows to make to for your little tail. I'm making it to fit like maybe 6 months to maybe, I don't know, maybe a year, 6 to maybe 9, 10 months, maybe a little bit bigger. If you want it for a younger baby, then you'll make less rows and just try them on them, because I don't have an actual baby here to try it on. I just have my little doll, and that's what I've been trying to do it. Although some people, I don't know, she's the size of like a 6-month-old, so I just tried on her, and this is the size I came up with. If you want to do it for a younger child, then you wouldn't need as many rows once we finish this row, or in an older child. You know, maybe if over a year old, you might want to try a few more rounds in the end. The waist should be okay because it's stretchy, you know. So here, once I get to my stitch marker, I can take it out, but I'm going to do an increase here. So I want you guys to do two double crochets in here. So now we should have 44 double crochets around when we finish. And then you just finish with one double crochet in every stitch. When you get to the end, you're going to slip stitch into the third chain. So go ahead and do that. I just wanted to let you know that there's going to be an increase in the start. See if it's here in the beginning and in the other end. So we have one increase and two increases in the round, in the whole row. So go ahead and finish one double crochet in every stitch. You're going to get to the end, do your last stitch, slip stitch into that stitch, and we'll be back for more. Okay, here I'm coming to the end, and I'm going to slip stitch into the third chain. You should have 48 stitches. I was short one, so I, instead of worrying about it once I counted it, I just added another increase to make sure I had my extra stitch. If you count your things and you're short one, it's not really critical, because this just is what the space would be. This is not really critical to the size. You could just add another increase in the end. Don't worry, don't get all freaked out. You don't have to pull out all your work, just add another stitch. So here for my next round, I'm going to chain three. 1, 2, 3. And now here we're going to repeat a pattern that we had done a few rows down. So here on the first stitch, where we had there, that same stitch, you're going to do a double crochet into there. So we have an increase in the beginning, and then one double crochet over each of the next stitches. 1 and 2. And now in my third chain, I'm going to do another increase. 1 and 2. And now one double crochet in each of the next two. So you're going to repeat that. Oops, let me see here. Lost that. You're going to repeat that all the way around. So here's one, and then my second one, two. Now on my third stitch, I'm going to do an increase once again. So I have one in there, and then a second one. So you're going to repeat that all the way around. So here we started with an increase, and then the next two stitches has one double crochet. The stitch after that, the third stitch, has an increase. Then one double crochet in each of the next two, and then your third stitch, an increase again. So do that all the way around. When you get to the end, we're going to slip stitch and then go on to the next round. Okay, here I finished my last stitch, so I'm going to do my slip stitch into the third chain here. And so now let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So we're on the 15th round here. So then we're going to go up by chaining 3, 1, 2, 3. Now from here, we're going to just do one double crochet in every round. So here, I'm going to do my first double crochet. And what I like to do is that I put in my stitch marker there. And we're going to do 30 rows of only one double crochet in every stitch. So this helps me start counting my rows of where I'm counting, where I'm adding my rows. If you have a child that's a little taller, you could add up to 35 rows. Or if you don't want it to be quite, because I'm making the tail to be kind of long, just to look like where it goes over the feet, you know, the long mermaid tail. If you don't want it to be that long, you could make it a little bit less rows. Just try it on the baby. But I'm gonna add 30 of these rows. So here, one double crochet in every stitch all the way around. When I get to my last stitch here, I'm gonna finish my last double crochet. I'm gonna slip stitch into the third stitch here. I'll have my stitch marker there so that I know how many rows I have. I'll slip stitch, chain three, and then continue until I have 30 rows with just one double crochet in every stitch. So go ahead and do that. I'll have to finish, let me finish up all my rows and we'll come back and start working on the waist. Okay, I have finished my last row here. So I've already just slip stitched it there. Okay, so I had just my last, let me pull out my last stitch here so I could just show you what I did. I should have waited till I was filming to do that for you guys. So here, I'm just going to slip stitch, and then I'm going to cut my tail. I'm leaving a little bit of a tail so that it's easier to sew in. If it's too short, it's a little bit harder to sew in. So that, I'm going to sew that in. So then you could see that that's my last stitch. And like I said, you want to try this, put the baby in there to see, to make sure their legs fit and everything. Here is a little bit, so you can see the tail here. So it starts narrow and then it gets up just like that. Okay, so here's that tail. So you're going to finish that part. And now we're going to go ahead and work on the fin. The fin, I'm going to make it in two pieces and then sew it to the sides of the bottom of the tail. Okay, so to begin the fin, I'm going to go ahead and just chain 28. I'm going to make my slip loop. Here, I think the camera's a little out of focus. Sorry, guys. And then here, you're just going to do your 28 chains. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to do my 28 chains, and then I'll come back here when I have my 28 chains. Okay, I have my 28 chains. So here, this does not count as a chain. That's just the loop that's on the hook. Here, so then on my third chain from my hook, 1, 2, 3, I'm going to start with a double crochet. So here I'm going to yarn over, meaning I wrap the yarn over my hook. I'm going to go into that third chain, 1, 2, excuse me, here I lost my count. Sorry, guys. Try this again. That one got kind of squished up there. Start this again. So here's 1, 2, and 3. I'm going to yarn over and go into the third chain, pull out my yarn, and I'm going to have three loops on my hook. Now I'm going to go through the first two, then the next two, and I'm going to do one double crochet at every stitch across. Okay, so I'm just yarn over, go in every stitch across, and I'm going to have this whole row there. Okay, so just go ahead and work one double crochet in every stitch until you finish all the entire chain, working it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and finish that. When we come back, we'll go ahead and start working on our next row. Okay, I completed my last double crochet. So now here, to go up, usually we do three, but I'm just going to be doing two to go up to these. Okay, so here I just go 1, 2. I'm going to turn my work over, and now here I'm only going to be working through the back loop of the chain, which means through the back part here. There's a front and a back. I'm only going through that back part. Because what I want to do is I'm going to have some little ridges on the thin. So I wanted to create that. And the way I do that is by working only in the back. Here, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to do a decrease over the first two. So I'm going to do two double crochets together. I yarn over. I'm going to go into the back loop only of that first, not this stitch, but this one here. So that next chain right here, going to go in there. I pull up my yarn. I'm going to pull through the two. Leave those two there, yarn over again, go into the next chain, only in the back part. I'm going to have four loops. I'm going to go through the first three, I have two left, and go through there. So I created two into one. And now I'm just going to do one double crochet in each back loop only, okay? So you're going to do that all the way across, and it's going to create a little ridge for us. So I want you to continue all the way until you finish every single stitch just like that. And if you can see that, it's going to create that little ridge for us. So one double crochet in the back loop only. Okay, I'm coming to my last stitch there. So I'm going to do my last double crochet in the back loop only. To go up to the next row, I chain two, one, two. Normally we have three for a double crochet. But in this tail, I'm making it a little bit less, a little shorter. And now here, there's no decreases. You just do one double crochet in every stitch, but only in the back loop. So we're skipping that first one because that's not that stitch right here. Yarn over, and we're going to go into our stitch right here. So you just start doing one double crochet in every stitch in the back loop only, okay? So you have that little chain, that stitch that looks like a little chain. So this is the front, that's the back. We're working only in the back loop. So do that in every stitch. And then your last stitch, of course, will be there here on top of this decrease that you did in the beginning. So go ahead and do one double crochet in every stitch, back loop only, so that we could create our little ridges. Okay, I'm coming to my last stitch here. So my last double crochet, there's on top of that stitch here, right there. Do my double crochet, go up to my next row. I'm gonna go ahead and do my two, one, two, turn my work over. And once again here, I'm gonna do another decrease. So over this first two stitches, this one and this one, I'm gonna turn it into one. Yarn over, go in there. Pull through the first two, yarn over again, go into my next stitch. I have four loops there, go through the first three, then my second two. And now here, I'm just going to do one double crochet in every stitch, only in the back portion. So I'm just making that little fin here, decreasing it in every other row. If you don't want your tail to be quite so wide as mine, you could decrease every row, but it will just be a thinner, a more narrow tail. So mine, if you can see it here, let me focus this. It's starting to get a little bit narrower in here, shorter. So this is going to be kind of like this, but I don't want it to be too pointy. That's why I'm doing it, you know, every other row. So go ahead and continue one double crochet in your back chain there only, and I'll come back and then we'll do the next row. Okay, I finished my last stitch. So now on this next row, there's no decreases. So chain two, turn your work over. I'm really sorry, this camera just keeps wanting to focus on me. So now here, we're just going to go in every stitch and we're just going to do one double crochet in the back loop only, okay? No decreases here. Just working in this back loop, doing a double crochet in every row. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I'll come back, and the next row is our decrease row, okay? So every other row, we're working a decrease, and then this, so here the next row is just one double crochet in each one. And we are going to continue that same pattern here. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until I have 9 rows. So here our first excuse me no until we have 7 rows, and then the 8th and 9th row are a little bit different. So here, go ahead and just finish. Gosh, I can't even read my own writing. That's pretty bad. So here, I'm just going to continue 1 double crochet in every stitch, and we'll come back and work our next decrease row together.